All right, I am about to begin a new build. This one's not for the haunt though. This one is actually something someone asked me to do. And it's a guillotine. It's not gonna be a working one, it's just gonna be a prop for photos. But yeah, should be interesting. I'm actually getting paid for it, so I gotta do a good job. Yeah, it's gonna be for the youth group, the people I did the haunted house for last year. They asked me to build them a guillotine for some festival that they have coming up at the end of April. So I've got about 6 weeks to get it done. They also want playing cards, you know, like from Alice in Wonderland, playing card soldiers. Guards, I guess, for another photo op. So, I'm gonna need my wife to help me on that because she's a lot more artistic than I am. So, yeah, should be fun. So, with that being said, let's get started. Well, so my camera just dropped, and apparently it has drop protection. So it shut itself off and before it could damage anything. Cool. All right, well, I need to work out here, out in my driveway, because if you take a look inside my garage, it's still pretty trashed, and I don't have any room to work in there. Plus, it's going to be 8 feet tall, and that's just with the garage door open. That won't fit, so have to work out here. But first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to build the two uprights that the blade would potentially go up and down. And to do that, I'm going to sandwich. Hang on here. I've got this. It's a 1x4, but it's pretty literally, you know, usually 1x4 is like 3/4 of an inch wide. Well, this one is an actual inch wide, so that will allow at least the headstock to slide up and down, because that's a more traditional 1x here. So I got two of those for each side right there, and then I'm gonna sandwich that in between in between this 1x4, I don't know what is that, 1x3 or something, I don't know. Anyway, it fits in between, it's going to fit in between this with like 3/4 of an inch or so for the headstock to slide up and down. So that's what I'm going to do now, and I'll show you what I'm talking about when I'm done. This is what I'm talking about here, because it's not quite 3/4 of an inch, but yeah, the headstock will slide up and down in that groove there, and should work, I hope. One thing I just noticed, I only got two pieces of wood for the uprights, so I gotta go back and get two more. What a treat. So yeah, also I see that I have to do some cutting up there because that's not the same height. So yeah, anyway, that's what I'm talking about here. So let me get these all screwed down and show you what I got. So I put the first screw in and lo and behold, I split it. So try to get some glue in there, put the screw back in there and get some glue in there and see if I can seal that split back up. Sucks. I also switched from the 1x5 I had. I switched from the 1x5 to the 1x6 because I wasn't happy with the amount of space that was there before. It was like a 1/2 inch and it wasn't going to be good enough. So I got a 1x6 and now I got about an inch and a half there. So so I'm gonna try to seal that split back up and see what happens from there. All right, this is what I got done for the day. I got the cross pieces built. There's the groove I was talking about. Oh, this is heavy. There you can see it. So these cross pieces right there are basically for me to keep it square until I get it put onto the feet. We'll do that tomorrow. It's starting to get dark now, so that's it for the night. I will start bright and early tomorrow morning and show you more then. All right, so there's the uprights. They have these 2x6s on the ground here. I made a mark here somewhere. Right there, it's 32 inches, both sides there. And those are 6 inches, those are 6 inches, so it should look pretty good. So I have pocket holes drilled right there and right there for stability. Hopefully that'll hold it long enough for me to get the pieces at 45 degrees put up and held in place. It should work. They're pretty strong. And here comes my faithful helper, Annie.
Hey, how you doing?
She's my haunt co-member. She's out here to help me because these things are way too heavy for me to do on my own. So, yep, that's what's next. All right. That's so far. Got the stabilization pieces on. And next thing I'm gonna do, I'm gonna put the headstock in. And see where it goes from there. Alright, what's next? Alright, I have the headstock in. It's not secured. That I need to put a block down here in the bottom so that this bottom piece doesn't slide. But it's secured in there pretty good right now. And then this will raise up. And since this is not quite as wide as that, I had an idea, but the one-inch board, the board that's in between there, only comes in 5-inch, and I need much bigger than that for the head. Otherwise, it runs a risk of breaking. So I need to put in here in that gap. I need to put some wedges in there, and then screw everything in and keep this loose. All right. Well, that is it for tonight. Tomorrow we'll do the blade and we'll probably start giving it a coat of stain. See what that looks like. I got a couple different ideas with that. I'll see what works the best. So anyhow, that's what I got done for the day. Pretty happy with the progress. We should have it all assembled tomorrow. All right, so that's it for the night. All right, so I started putting the stain on there. Waiting to rub this part out. Yeah, boy, just putting the stain on sucks. But I distressed the front a little bit with whatever I could find in my garage. So hopefully it'll look good. I might not get the stains so dark. I don't know what to do to make these come out. because it's pretty dark there. I'm hoping that inside these gouges and stuff, it'll be darker, but I don't know. The stain's so dark to begin with. Maybe this won't leave it on long. I don't know. We'll see. All right, well, that's where I'm at now. All right. It's not completely done yet, but... that is, for the most part, I'll do touch-ups tomorrow. I got a couple more things to add. Then just doing the details. So some of the distressing that I did came out really good. It was that crack from earlier that came out real nice. It got real cloudy. It didn't rain. Anyway, that's that for tonight. Tomorrow I should be almost done with this. I got to build the bench for it. And that's it so far. You know when I got more. Also, freaking spilled on my driveway. Oh well, hopefully I'll come up with a pressure washer or something. Alright, that's it for the night. Alright, I am working on the bench now that's gonna go behind it for people to lay down on. Doing the pocket holes right now for the frame for the bench, so that's what I'm working on right now. Already did those holes. Go put it on the bench. Pieces are in here. I'm gonna get the side pieces in and then the legs, and just kind of support those a little bit and the bench will be done. So I'll show you more when that gets a little more completed. It's not too exciting to watch. So. All right, well, done with the bench. Made some modification because I didn't like how far apart the legs here were. They were inside here, underneath here, when this was out more, more towards the end. There wasn't very much space for the legs to have any kind of support. So I moved the legs out to the edge and then put a new piece on here on the end for support. And then I put this support down here on the bottom. And it seems pretty well. You can't really tell sitting up here because it's sitting on a piece of plywood. But it seems pretty sturdy. And I'm pretty happy with how it turned out. I'm starting to stain. Started out with this weathered oak, and it just wasn't. I wanted a contrast from that to this, and the weathered oak just didn't look like there was anything on it. So I put on this early American. And it's not as dark as that over there, so I think it'll be a good contrast. So I am in the process of finishing that stain, and I'll show you that when it's all done. All right, there's the bench where it's going. And as you can tell, the difference in the colors. No, I just want a contrast. I'm not sure it looked great, but yeah, I just wanted a contrast. All right, so that's that. Everything is stained. I put that up there. Just not sure I like that. It looks very Chinese, and that's kind of not what I'm going for. So I don't know. I'm gonna have to see if that grows on me. Alright, there's the headstock in, I guess we'll call it that. And decided just to take that off. I wasn't happy with how it was looking. So there's that in. I'm getting ready to put the blade together. And I will put that in. It's next. All right, so since I wasn't putting that big 4x4 in over there, I needed to come up with a way to stash the pulley up there on top. So I drilled a bunch of holes in here and then chiseled out a little bit there, and that seems to fit in there pretty good. So I'll just stick that up in between the two slots up there, and that should sit up there okay. I'm just waiting for the paint to dry on the silver part of the blade there. As soon as I get done with that, I'll attach the big wing piece sitting up on top of that compressor there. And we're just about done after that. Right, I'll show you that when I get done. All right, got the blade on there. Yeah. And, I don't know, I might drop it down a little bit because with the eye bolt that I have that's coming out of the top there, I want you to be able to see that. I'll have to see what it looks like when I have it screwed in. It's still sort of drying now. I tried to put it in earlier and the paint started coming off in my finger, so I need to let it dry and all that before I start messing with it anymore. So I'll see what it looks like once I have the rope and the and the eye bolt and all that run up through there, and it's going to come out another eye bolt here, and then I have a, I don't know, one of those hitch things to put on down here. Other than that, I think it's done. I gotta add the blood to the blade. I'm gonna smear blood up this way, put some splash up here, up on the top here, and then run some blood down the front of the bottom neck wall. Got some perma blood the other day. I'm pretty excited to use that. Once I get that on and get everything, the eye bolts and all that, and I'm gonna call this done. And I gotta start on the card guards. So, all right, well, once I get everything all complete, I will shoot a video of that and then call this good. All right, I'll show you that when I'm done. All right, it is all done. I got a rope on there. You can see it. Got a rope on there. And down through the eye hole there, and then one of these hitches here. And yeah, it's all done. I was supposed to deliver this on Monday, but my trailer there has a fell off. I was trying to change the tire. It's got a flat, yeah, I don't know if you can see it in there. It's got a flat tire. I can't get the tire off. Quite honestly, I don't really care about it right now. I'm gonna just rent one on Thursday and deliver it on Friday now. So yeah, it's all done now. I do have to put one last thing down on this, the bottom neck thing here. I gotta put a screw block in so it doesn't slide down. And I gotta secure the pulley up there. Other than that, it is ready to go. So anyway, thanks for watching through all of this, and if you got any questions, let me know. I'll do my best to answer them. All right, take care. I'll see you when I start building Halloween.